back through, and I started going through some of the Old Testament books, and I forget what a joy it is to read some of the Old Testament. Some of the Old Testament I just find absolutely wonderful. And you know, this time of year, we tend to reflect back on the past year and look forward to the beginning of the new year. And I think that this reading I have this morning kind of does that in 1 Chronicles chapter 16, starting in verse 7. And here it tells us what David does and says. But he looks back and he's also looking forward. So I'm going to read verse 7 through verse 36, but I'm not going to talk about it all because it's pretty much self-explanatory. He tells us to remember what the Lord has done and to look forward to what the Lord is going to do. Verse 7, chapter 16, 1 Chronicles, it says, "Then on that day David delivered first this psalm to thank the Lord into the hand of Asaph and his brother. Give thanks unto the Lord, call upon his name, make known his deeds among the people." It's good to tell people what God has done for us. "Sing unto him, sing psalms unto him. Talk ye all of his wondrous works. Glory ye in his holy name. Let the heart of them rejoice that seek the Lord. Seek the Lord and his strength, seek his face continually. Remember his marvelous works that he hath done, his wonders, and the judgments of his mouth. O ye seed of Israel, his servant, ye children of Jacob, his chosen ones, he is the Lord our God, his judgments are in all the earth. Be ye mindful always of his covenant, the word which he has commanded to a thousand generations, even of the covenant which he made with Abraham and of his oath unto Isaac, and hath confirmed the same to Jacob for a law, and to Israel for an everlasting covenant, saying, Unto thee will I give the land of Canaan, of the lot of your inheritance, when ye were but few, even a few, and strangers in it. And when they went from nation to nation, and from one kingdom to another people, he suffered no man to do them wrong. Yea, he reproved kings for their sakes, saying, Touch not mine anointed, and do my prophets no harm. Sing unto the Lord all the earth. Show forth from day to day his salvation. Declare his glory among the heathen, his marvelous works among all nations. For great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised. He is also to be feared above all gods. For all the gods of the people are idols, but the Lord made the heavens.
Yeah.
Glory and honor are in his presence. Strength and gladness are in his place. Give unto the Lord, ye kindreds of the people. Give unto the Lord glory and strength. Give unto the Lord the glory due unto his name. Bring an offering and come before him. Worship the Lord in the beauty of his holiness. Fear before him all the earth, for the world also shall be stable, that it shall not be moved. Let the heavens be glad, and let the earth rejoice, and let men say among the nation, The Lord reigneth. Let the sea roar and the fullness thereof, let the fields rejoice and all that is therein. Then shall the trees of the wood sing out at the presence of the Lord, because he cometh to judge the earth. O give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever. Amen. And say ye, Save us, O God, of our salvation, and gather us together, and deliver us from the heathen, that we may give thanks to thy holy name, and glory in thy praise. Blessed be the Lord God of Israel forever and ever. And all the people said, Amen, and praise the Lord.
Amen.
At this time, we'll go ahead and I'll take up this morning's offering. Dear Heavenly Father, we come to your throne of grace this morning just thanking you for this opportunity to give back. We ask you, dear Heavenly Father, that you take this offering and use it for that building of your kingdom. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.